Hey guys, so this video is going to be summer perfume favorites that I've been wearing all summer that I really, really love. Some of them are oldies but goodies, others are new that I don't think I've talked about yet. So I have a bunch, so let's just get started. I'm going to just briefly touch upon this one. I'm sure you will, if you followed me in the past, you already know which one I'm talking about, but hands down, favorite perfume of all time. Any season, Bronze Goddess. This is by Estee Lauder, and the bottle looks like that, and it is my absolute positive favorite perfume. Nothing else smells like it. I get so many compliments when I wear it. It's become my signature fragrance, and I absolutely loved it. Love it. I've turned my mom onto it. I've turned a lot of people onto it. It's just the beach. It is the beach suntan lotion, yumminess, warmth. I absolutely love it. It is limited edition. It normally comes out in the spring and the summer, but absolutely, hands down, my favorite perfume. Okay, next up is from Philosophy. And this isn't a perfume, it's a body spritz, but I consider it a perfume. It's called Message in a Bottle. Looks like that. And I just think that's just an adorable name for a little body spritz for the summer. And if you hear that little beep, that's just my, lets me know that I'm getting an email. Yes, so it's from Philosophy. I got mine off of QVC, and it is, trying to think if they had a little explanation what it smells like, but it really doesn't. It's very oceanic, it's very clean and fresh, and picture, you know, a morning when you're down at the beach and you wake up and the seagulls, and you just smell like the fresh, clean linen scent. Oh, it just smells so good. And even though it's a body spritz or spray, the scent lasts a very, very long time. Love this for the summer. I wear this all year round as well, but I especially like it in the spring and summer just because it just reminds me again of the beach and just, I don't know, it's a lighter scent. It's not something that, you know, has musk or anything in it, and I absolutely love it. So there's that. Sticking with Philosophy, I have two other perfumes that I'll talk about. First one is Falling in Love Summer. And again, it's by Philosophy. And this one is a take on the original Falling in Love. If you guys know what that smells like, that's a mix of berries, sweet on the sweeter side. This Falling in Love Summer is a take on that. How would I describe this one? It smells like the original Falling in Love because it does have the berry and the vanilla mix to it. It's just a little bit lighter than that, not as deep of a scent, a little bit more candy-ish, I guess you could say, and it smells delicious. Bought it off of QVC, and it's a great one for summer, especially if you like those very sweet, candy-like, very girly type perfumes. Also by Philosophy is Summer Grace. And this one is more on the citrus side, more on the citrus floral side, I would say. Very, very light, bright. I don't know why I think of the color yellow. Not that that has any kind of basis on scent, but just very cheerful, very clean, and more on the citrusier side. So that is Summer Grace. Next up is this one. What attracted me to this one first, obviously, is the bottle. It's absolutely adorable. And it's a Little Mermaid. I just have this displayed out front because I just think she is just absolutely adorable. I'm sure a lot of you have guessed. It's by, I can't even read it because it's so small on the bottom. It's the Harajuku, I think that's how you say it, Lovers, and the scent is G, but it's the summertime one. This is Gwen Stefani's perfume line, And oh, it smells so good. This one is a little hard to explain. It's a typical, I want to say it's a perfume scent. I can't pick out, I know that's probably a weird description, a perfume scent. They're all perfumes, but this one, it's crisp and it has a little bit of a few notes, almost kind of similar to Message in a Bottle. Oceanic, I would say. Clean, crisp. Yeah, beachy, obviously, because she's the Little Mermaid, so absolutely love that. Love Escada Into the Blue. This one just smells, oh, it just smells so good. Again, Message in a Bottle, oceanic, clean, a little bit of a boyfriend type scent because it has those notes that are not, I don't get a feminine scent with this. I get a very like, oh, what's the word I want to say? Invigorating and exhilarating type scent. Very, very uplifting and beachy as far as oceanic type scent. So love that. Then we have Michael Kors Island. This one has more of a powdery type scent to it. It's more of a softer, very feminine, powdery, fresh, clean scent. Yeah, more on the softer, feminine, powdery type end. Very light. I also love Jennifer Aniston's perfume. Is it just called Jennifer Aniston? I think it is. But that's her perfume. I'm sure everybody's smelled this one. This one is very beachy, very suntan lotion, different, totally different though than the Bronze Goddess. Bronze Goddess is more, I smell coconut, I smell musk, sweet. Jennifer Aniston is more along the lines of old-fashioned type copper tone smell, if that makes any sense. I also love Lily Pulitzer Squeeze. So cute. And this is citrus. Bright citrus, juicy, but a touch of musk to it. Yeah, I guess that's how I would describe it. And it is, I don't know, it's just inviting, like enveloping and inviting type scent. So love that. I have five more, guys. Also, my mom purchased this for me. I believe it was for my birthday a year ago or 2 years ago. Could it have been? Yes. And this is my second bottle. I went through the first one and I've purchased my second. I've been through 900 of the original ones. But this is Bronze Goddess Capri. This was also limited edition. And this one smells very, very bold, very on the muskier side, sexy side. Think of summer nights, a good one for evening. Very, very grown up. And when I think of Capri, this is the type of scent that I would picture the women in Capri that would what they would wear. Very sophisticated summer. So, love that. I'm not really sure how you pronounce this. I think it's Hanae Mori, Mori. And this is the original one. I know she has a bunch of different ones with colored butterflies, I think, but this is the original one. And this one is sweet, sweet mixed with a little like coconut. a little musk, I guess you would say. This one's a little hard one to describe. Very, very soft, very feminine, summer. I kind of think of the boardwalk scents, if that would make any sense with that one. But that's how I would describe this one. Yummy. Yummy tastes. Yummy not tasting. Yummy smelling. Here's a really, really cheap and inexpensive, it's not a perfume, but it's by Axe. And it is for her, and it's called Anarchy. I believe that's how you would jumble all those letters together. And this smells really, really good, guys. I know most women wouldn't even think of Axe for women, but they do. I think this is the only scent that they have right now. But it's very fruity and invigorating and a little sweet. It's not citrus. When I say fruity, I would say more of like, I don't know, peach and grapefruit and along those type of lines. But, yeah, it smells really good. So next time, like, you're in Target or the food store, take a sniff of this one. It smells very good. This I picked up. I used to have this when I was younger, and I bought this, I think, at CVS. But it's just Cotton Candy by Prince Machiavelli. What is this, like, $5, I think? Typical cotton candy scent. Exactly like cotton candy. That just smells so good to me. That just reminds me of the boardwalk and summer. Love to just spritz this on and you just smell so good. You smell like a dessert. So smells exactly like cotton candy. And then finally, this body spray from Victoria's Secret. It's a new one. It's called Heavenly in Paradise. And this is again more of the perfumey, more oceanic, more musk, sexier, Victoria's Secret-y type scent. I know a lot of their scents kind of mesh together, and but I really, really like this one, and I love the coloring in the bottle and stuff. So that's it, guys. That's my picks for summer perfumes that I've been wearing and loving. Leave me a comment down below. Let me know what you've been loving. I love perfumes. I love hearing about them. And kind of describe them to me too, so I have a little bit of a heads up. One thing I'm not a fan of, I know a lot of people are, I don't care for the scent of patchouli. I know that's extremely popular. It's just not one of mine. And I don't care for the scent lavender. I know, again, that's another top-notch scent that so many people like. It's just not one of my favorites. So, if you know of a perfume that doesn't have those two scents in it, leave me a comment below and I'll talk to y'all soon. Bye, guys.